If you've been following along in our Suite Analytics series, you should have a pretty good grasp of the basics of NetSuite datasets and workbooks. Now, let's shift gears a bit and tackle NetSuite reports. In future videos, we'll get deeper into reports, but for now, we just need to understand the basics of navigating NetSuite reports. To start with, let's get an idea of what exactly reports are in NetSuite. What kinds of reports are there, and how are they different from NetSuite workbooks? Essentially, NetSuite reports are just another way that users can see the breakdown of key data. Reports are not as visually appealing as workbooks, but they serve the same function of gathering and presenting data that has been stored in NetSuite. NetSuite comes with standard reports, which cover most of the main record types, but these standard reports can be customized to better meet your company's needs. Reports can also be created entirely from scratch. NetSuite differentiates between financial reports and non-financial reports. The type of report you're viewing will impact the exact options that are available to you on the report. So how can you access and create a standard NetSuite report? You have two main options. First, you could view the complete list of standard reports in your center's reports menu dropdown. In the menu navigation, you can see both the higher categories of reports as well as the specific reports that fall under those categories. Alternatively, you could access this same list of reports from the reports dashboard. On the reports dashboard, you can expand any of the reports categories to see the lists of reports within those categories. To create a new standard report, then, you would simply select the type of report you need. The reports you would access by clicking on a report name are all summary reports, but notice that some of the reports also have a detailed report option available. Let's go ahead and open a financial report. Note that some of the non-financial reports might have slightly different options available, but the options in the financial reports are fairly common. For the sake of an example, we'll choose the report Open Invoices. In this standard Open Invoices report, we can see several columns of information that NetSuite has pre-configured for this report. The report is fully expanded when we first open it, but we can collapse the categories within this report by selecting the minus sign to the right of each category. This standard summary report doesn't come with an associated standard detail report, but if it did, then there would be a View Detail link to the right of the report name that would take you directly to the detail report. At the bottom of the report, notice the date options you have for this report. The date field gives you dynamic options like today, yesterday, this month today, last fiscal year today, etc. This report also allows you to filter results by a specific as of date. Some reports will have slightly different date options though, like allowing you to set date ranges for the report. The subsidiary context field is available for users with OneWorld, and it allows you to restrict the results to a certain subsidiary. Some reports will also come with a column field that enables you to easily pivot the data, though the Open Invoices report does not have this option. Reports with a column field enable you to pivot the data by type, department, location, or subsidiary, to name a few of the possible options. And finally, the Find field allows you to quickly search for a specific result that you need to see. This option is especially helpful when viewing reports with large quantities of data. Once you have set your desired sorting and filtering options, select the Refresh button at the bottom of the page to see the report results with your selections applied. You'll notice on the report that you also have several options in the footer toolbar. Let's take a look at this toolbar and the options it provides. The first toolbar option allows you to change the view of the report from a plain white background to a grid. With this option, you can also set the expand level for the report, display the report's official title, and set the report to show drill down balloons. The next two toolbar options are the collapse and expand buttons, which allow you to quickly navigate between hierarchy levels on the report. Depending on the type of report you're viewing, you may also have the option of putting the information into a graph so you can visualize the results. The graph would have customizable parameters that allow you to display the exact data you wish to see. The next four buttons on the footer give you exporting options, allowing you to export the report to Excel, PDF, CSV, or Word. And the final three options you have are to print the report results, to email them, and to schedule a specific time for the report to run. That's a broad overview of what it looks and feels like to navigate within a standard NetSuite report. In our next video, we'll dive into creating a custom NetSuite report, so stay tuned. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, let us know by hitting the like button. And to learn more about how SuiteRep can help you with all of your NetSuite needs, visit us at suiterep.com.